Hey, Ross here from Signum Audio, and welcome to our walkthrough video showcasing our new SKYE Clipper plugin. Where I'll be going through all its features and showing you guys how to use them. SKYE Clipper is a clipper and saturator plugin that can be used for mixing, mastering, and creative sound design. It comprises of 7 different clipping types, utilizing our sophisticated proprietary real-time anti-aliasing algorithms with a sleek, feature-rich, and yet simple user interface. Before I get stuck into this walkthrough, I'd like to just explain what a clipper is and why you might want to use one. A clipper will slice off the signal above its threshold, resulting in distortion. The harder you push the signal into clipping, the greater the coloration, adding distortion and harmonic saturation. This can greatly affect transient material by increasing its energy and perceived loudness, while colouring it with some grit and crunch. This means clippers are a great tool for controlling the peaks of a signal, while adding some density to the body. It can also be used for adding saturation to a sound. Depending on the clipping type, they give similar results to tape saturation, and it can be used as a bit of a loudness machine. They can be used on single tracks, group buses, or even the master channel, and I'll give examples of all of these in this tutorial. Upon opening SKYE Clipper, you're introduced to this main view. At the top, we have a preset manager and some menu buttons, which include a master bypass, a graph reset, an information window, and also an expand or collapse button. On the right hand side, we have our vertical meters, which display our output of the plugin, our gain reduction, and also a small graph which displays our currently selected clipping type's shape. In the middle, we have our main history view, which records our output, our RMS, and our gain reduction. At the top, we have the overview of the history, which we can use to navigate and use to zoom in and out if we wish. And also a readings rectangle at the top left with the numerical readouts. And finally, at the bottom, we have our control panel, which holds all our parameters, and we can move it around if we find it getting in the way of our recorded history. In this first example, I'm going to use SKYE Clipper on a single track. I have a snare here, and I'm going to use the clipper to shave off its peaks, helping tame its dynamics while adding some saturation to its overall sound. There are a few different ways you can use the clipper to achieve the desired results. In this case, I'm going to bring the threshold down till I've taken the amount of gain reduction I want off and have a sound that I like. Afterwards, I'll use the post gain to adjust the output level I'm after. Now we can see the input coming in before clipping and the output after. Saving a few dB by taming the peaks, by actually hearing the snare at a similar or even louder level as we've increased the perceived loudness. In this next example, I will use SKYE Clipper on a drum bus. This will again help shave off and tame the peaks, while helping bring out some of the smaller detailed elements in the group. This time, I'm going to keep the gain link on, and now increase the pre-gain to push the signal into clipping. The gain link will automatically adjust the post-gain to keep a unity gain, allowing volume gain increases or decreases to not affect our decision making. If you'd like to adjust the gain after dialing in our settings, we can just turn the link off and adjust the post-gain. Again, comparing our input and output now, we have saved some headroom while maintaining our loudness. In this third example, I will use the clipper in a mastering situation. I'm going to use one of my favourite types for this, the warm type, as it gives a similar effect to tape saturation. I'll set my threshold to -1 dBFS, and then I'll push the signal into clipping without adjusting the post gain. Personally, I feel like less is more when using it on the master, so I'll aim for a small amount of gain reduction, but feel free to use as little or as much as you like. Also, since I'm trying to dial in a small amount, I can drag the vertical scale next to the meters to zoom in, which gives me greater visual accuracy when adjusting the parameters. Now we need to be careful when clipping on the master, as clipping will cause overshoots, and this is why it works great in series with a true peak brick wall limiter, which if placed after in the chain will catch the clipper's overshoots. I have our ultra transparent butte limiter to thank in this case. The last example I'd like to show you guys is using SKYE Clipper as a sound design tool to add some saturation to a sound. Here I have a synth pad in this track, and I wanted to get it sounding a bit dirtier. So I decided to use the bright saturator type, which has an adjustable softness control, which we can use to soften the curve. We've also added some features that we thought would be useful. The dry gain switch lets you apply the pre-gain to the dry signal, useful for parallel processing. And we can also resize the history to create a slender vertical mode if we wish to just see the controls in meters. SKYE Clipper is also available as a surround version, which can be used on multi-channel configurations. Lastly, I'd like to show you guys some analysis of our anti-aliasing technology in action. Here we have a frequency spectrum analyzer of a sine wave around 4 kHz being clipped by another clipper using a hard algorithm set at 4 times oversampling. We can see all the aliasing artifacts it has produced by all these frequencies being reflected back into our signal. Now, using the same settings, we can have a look at SKYE Clipper. We can see it produces much less aliasing in the signal, meaning less unwanted aliasing artifacts in the audio. And here is an overlay of the two to see the differences. So that's it from me, and we hope you enjoyed this walkthrough video of our new SKYE Clipper plugin. And you can pick up a trial from signumaudio.com.